Greetings. I would really like to ask you a question, brother. You have told me that Allah guides Muslims. Well, my question is simple, brother. In fact, it is only one word. How? But before you answer, I'd like to just explain the Christian teaching. The God of Abraham leads Christians. And I can explain exactly how God leads Christians. Romans 8:14, "For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God." The Spirit of God is the comforter that lives in Christians, brother. John 14:17, "Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but you know him, for he dwells with you and shall be in you." John 14:17 says, "Even the Spirit of truth, and he shall be in you." The Spirit of God is the comforter that lives in Christians, brother. Brother, that is why Christians seem so shocked and amazed that folks in Islam dare try to claim Muhammad is the comforter. We know who the comforter is, and we know that we know, brother. So when a Christian says they are led by God, we know how God leads us. How then does Allah lead you? Allah cannot enter his creation according to Islam. I am sure you have heard it, brother, and you understand why you must say it. I have heard you tell it and others from Islam tell it. You must say Allah cannot enter his creation to argue against Jesus being God in the flesh. So I understand why you must make the argument that Allah cannot enter his creation. But that creates a problem for your religion, brother. The problem is inconsistency. By declaring Allah cannot as an excuse against one fact, Jesus as God in the flesh, you are declaring Allah cannot enter creation to guide you. For sure, Allah cannot enter you and live in you as the God of Abraham has promised to do. So how does Allah guide you? You must surely answer by the Quran, given as a guidance. Surah 2:2, "This book, whereof there is no doubt, is a guidance unto those who fear Allah." When you seek guidance, how do you expect Allah to answer? The Torah and Bible speak of hearing God's voice. Does the Quran declare you can hear Allah's voice? Think carefully, brother, because that question is a can of condemnation for Muhammad. Does the Quran declare you can hear Allah's voice? If the Quran says you can hear Allah's voice, that proves the Quran false, brother. If the Quran says you can hear Allah's voice, and you ever hear Allah's voice, and you ever dare to speak Allah's words out loud, you are a prophet. And that opens the can of condemnation for Muhammad, because he claimed he was the last prophet, the seal of the prophets. No more prophets after him. None. Ever. So your Allah can never communicate with you. Your Allah can never speak to you. Your Allah can never teach you the truth directly. I'm sure you may be thinking that Christianity has the same exact problem. But that is not correct, brother, because prophecy still expressly occurs in Christianity. Jesus was the last prophet like Moses. But what does that really mean? Basically this: under the Old Covenant, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, would descend on a prophet. 1 Samuel 19:23, "And he went thither to Naoth and Ramah, and the Spirit of God was upon him also, and he went on and prophesied until he came to Naoth in Ramah. Then the Spirit of God would lift or leave the prophet of God, and they would prophesy no more. And that is the difference, brother, between the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, being upon a prophet versus in a Christian, in every Christian. And prophets are actually an office or a purposed position of the church which God established. Ephesians 4:10, he who descended is himself also he who ascended far above all the heavens, so that he might fill all things. And he gave some as apostles, and some as prophets, and some as evangelists, and some as pastors and teachers, for the equipping of the saints for the work of the service, for the building up of the body of Christ. So these prophets and the other four offices are after Jesus. They are to build up the church, which is called the body of Christ. So there is no issue, brother, for Christianity to have God lead men, even to the point of there being prophets of God after Jesus. Christian prophets do not fulfill the same office as Jesus, the last prophet like Moses. But getting back to my original question, when you seek guidance, how do you expect Allah to answer? Do you allow the Quran to fall open and throw darts at it to pick a surah? I've known some Christians who I suspect probably used this same technique. But clearly that is not what God has intended. And we have established you can never hear from your Allah, or else that would make you a prophet, and Muhammad and the Quran liars. How then can Allah lead you? I believe the actual answer is revealed in the fatalism of Islam's typical answer. Inshallah. You simply must accept that every event in life is caused by your Allah to guide you. He must guide you with taps and bumps, like a hockey player guides the puck, or like a footballer guides the football down the pitch with nudges and kicks. He simply cannot use any form of direct communication, as we have proven. But the Quran says over and over, Allah will guide you. And that seems like an empty and unfulfillable commitment, brother. For those Christians watching, rejoice that God lives in you. Learn to listen and be led by the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of adoption which we have received. And Christians, know that you know that you know. Islam offers nothing to you. The Allah of Islam cannot enter his creation, cannot live in you, cannot lead you, cannot guide you. And for you who call yourself Muslim, you can ask God to come and live in you. Revelation 3:20, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him, and will sup with him, and he with me. This is the good news, my Muslim brother. This is the gospel, the Injil which the Lord Jesus brought, my Muslim brother. If you have any questions about this video and how to ask God to come into your heart, please ask, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.